game on. It's game on.
We are
big on sports. Big on sports.
Now, over the weekend, the National Rally Championship got underway down in Mbarara with Yasmin Gatz doing it again, claiming the fast event of the year 2019. We also had the two-wheel drive, and that was owned by Godfrey Nsereko, who had the final say during that encounter. He's in studio to take us through that experience down in Mbarara as he looks forward to another successful 2019. Good evening, sir. How are you, sir?
I'm good.
You're good?
Yeah,
hi. For the first time we get to meet, I usually see you in the cars having plenty of fun. Whether it's fun or you competing, it doesn't matter. But you've been quite the driver from last year to this year. What does that say about Godfrey Nsereko? Because we've seen you time and again, you know, putting very good races. Mm-hmm. But over the weekend, the two-wheel drive has become now part of you. Take us through that experience and how did you manage to maneuver through and cross the finish line?
Yeah, it was our first time, the crew of Dr. Nsereko Godfrey and JB Musisi. It was our first time in two-wheel drive. Last year we were in Clubman Rally Championship.
Yes.
Because it was our first year in competition. And we were the only newcomers in the two-wheel drive category.
That was
the
other season.
Yeah, this season. And all the other drivers were basically, they had already...
They had been there before.
Yeah, they had been there before. So it was really challenging for us. There was a lot of tension. We didn't know what to expect so much, but we tried to prepare and did our best, which is have fun in the car, have fun in the race, and step it.
Just out of curiosity, Nsereko, when you look at that performance, it being your first time, how much of that nervousness and that tension played a role in your victory? Because then I would imagine an underdog race driver coming into this particular competition, not a favorite, but somehow managing to get the job done. Mm-hmm. How much of that nervousness, or should I say a willingness to race in an event that you know wasn't a favorite, how much of that do you think contributed to your victory over the weekend?
Well, actually, day one, at the end of day one, we were already in third.
In
two-wheel drive. Because some of the people who had been in that category earlier, they took advantage of some of the faults that came with the car and so on. But specifically the tension is good. I mean, this is an adrenaline-driven sport, and one of the things that we do is to control it. You have to be calculative. You have to know where to pick up the time. You have to know where to accept that at this juncture I'll have to lose some seconds, but I can gain from here. So we took it as we always take it. We take it fast, but cautious, and eventually because much as we're underdogs, it was our first time in the two-wheel drive. These drivers have been seeing us in the CRC. We are taking on cars which are more powerful than the two-wheel drives.
More faster.
Yeah, we won against Evos and Subarus in CRC. So they knew that these guys are new, but these guys are not.
They can
easy.
Be a threat.
Yeah. So,
John Bosco, Musisi, your co-driver. What is the partnership besides, you know, what is that relationship like outside racing?
We have actually become friends over time, and the partnership is very important, especially in when you're in the cockpit. Because sometimes you get tense. Sometimes someone has to remind you that, hey, we have a rally to win. We have a section to win. We have to be cautious. So we've become friends over time. He's actually my clearing agent as we speak, because he's into a lot of clearing. Yeah. So the partnership has actually grown, and each and every rally. We keep learning one or another thing from each other, and you know, when you're friends in that cockpit, it's a bit different. It's not transactional. It is something you're in the both of you, and it's really great.
I'm obviously it. Yeah. Well, looking at the numbers, the time that you lost was about 1 hour 32 minutes and 40 seconds and 9 microseconds. When you look at those figures, these are impressive figures, by the way. As a navigator or as a co-driver, your job is to, you know, direct where to turn and, you know, let the driver know, which is in this case it's you, how much time have we lost and how much time have we regained. When you look at these numbers here, does it cross your mind that they could have easily been regained in as much as they were lost at the time? Because then the numbers will always win your races. The faster you go, the more chances you stand in winning a race. When you look at that particular number, the 1 hour plus, did you think that it would be regained even after it being lost going into the second section and the third section?
Yeah, usually the numbers, we usually have our targets per section.
Do you focus on the numbers anyway?
Usually during our reconnaissance, we can try to time a section, and you know that if a section is 26 kilometers, maybe we can do it in 18 minutes. Mm-hmm. So, and usually the two-wheel drive cars, we start much later than the bigger cars, the Evos and the Subarus. Mm. So sometimes you get the results trickling in before you have started. Mm-hmm. Like that particular section, you hear just Mangat has made 18 minutes.
So then you know where to improve.
So you're like, okay, now I think we're saying 18 minutes. I think for us we might do 20 because our car is not as powerful as theirs. Mm-hmm. So once you're out of a section, you're eager to calculate how much you've done, how much has your competition done. Mm-hmm. And that is part of the game. You know, it's not just about racing and stepping on the accelerator, but you have to be calculative. Sometimes if by the last section, your competition is 3 minutes away, then you don't have to take too many risks, because it's unlikely that someone will catch up on the 3 minutes. Mm-hmm. Maybe unless you're maybe targeting, maybe to now, like for us, our target is to be in the top 10. Mm-hmm. So 15th, and well, we're not very happy with that, but we're happy because all the cars that are above us were really very powerful cars. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So,
well, obviously, talk about your car. That's Toyota Alex. End of the day, did you guys proud with John Bosco? Let's walk away from you and John Bosco. Let's now talk about Yas Mangat. He owned the show down in Bar, of course, knowing that the event was never completed because of the incident that walked away. I'd like to pick your mind on Yas Mangati's performance with his very fast car, the Evo 10. Do you think he could be the champion this season? Too early to ask, but do you see him win it? Knowing that Arthur Blake Jr. had a very good outing, we also had Susan Mwonge with a very terrible outing out there, 11th. But when you look at Yas Mangat, can he lift it this season?
What I can say right now is that, like you said, it's too early to determine. If you look at the top 12 cars, actually, if you look at the top 11 positions from the Mbarara Rally, each of those has the potential to take the championship.
Right from the first
to
half
the
second,
yes.
Hassan Ali third,
yes.
Ronald Tebogu was the fourth.
Exactly. Mobiru and all the rest, each of them has a chance. And I know that the crew of Yas Mangat and Joseph Kamya, once they're into this, they are so prepared. He's a smart driver. You rarely get him having a scratch on his car, and he has
over the weekend he had a very big scratch on his car.
Yeah, that was very big. Yeah, so I think he stands a very good chance, considering that he already has 100 points in the bag. But you can't undermine the others who have got 80-70 points, and yeah, clearly. But I think he has a very good chance of taking the championship.
Still on the subject of Yas Mangat, very unfortunate he claimed a life during that race in Mbarara. When you look at such incidences, of course, last year, a speedy car ran into a section of fans, claiming a life and injuring other viewers on the day. But when you look at such incidences, yes, I know FMU has done something about safety, which is very key. We want our fans who go down to watch the races to go back home in one piece. When you look at such incidences, what do they say about safety, especially with a sport like motor rally?
What I can say is that FMU tries to do its part. The question of whether what it does is sufficient or not, I may not be able to determine. But my own experience also is that we have a group of fans who are adamant, like sensitization is done in the community, especially for the road sections, that cars will be coming, there will be rally cars on such and such a day, please don't allow the kids to on the road, please don't drive your borders, don't do this. And some people are adamant, they're like, no, for us we can manage. Personally, we had a very bad experience in Barra. You know, we phoned a taxi and a tipper in the road.
On the racetrack?
Yes, on the racetrack. And our car was right in the middle of the mix. It wasn't like we're the last, it wasn't like we're the first. So these are people who have been sensitized. The local leaders, the local communities, the police was there on ground.
But where are the marshes in all this?
Yes.
Because clearly, if there's a tipper and a taxi, they should be told to divert or to get off the racetrack.
Exactly. So sometimes the challenge is that some of these roads have very many roads branching off.
Mm-hmm.
So you may find that there are over 20 roads branching off a 15-kilometer track. So FMU and the organizers try to put tape on some
yes,
of them.
They are marked.
Yes, they are
barricaded
marked.
Barricaded or something.
They are marked, but some people come from their compounds. His compound is right next to the road.
Mm-hmm.
So he gets into the road, he has seen cars passing, mm-hmm. and he thinks he can get away with it. So it's really unfortunate, but we also, fans should know that it is your safety first. For us, when we are sitting in the car, it is my responsibility to see that I'm fastened, my helmet is on, my hands device is on, my, you know, everything is safe, my fire extinguisher is working, you know. So I make sure I'm safe first.
Do you ever worry about speed? I mean, while you're racing and trying to hit the numbers, do you ever worry about speed or hitting someone?
Oh, well, sometimes you get a scare.
Mm-hmm.
I got my first scare in Hoima in 2017,
mm-hmm.
when I was still a navigator. And sometimes you think it can happen, especially in those, you know, we call them crests, like at the top of the hill when you don't know what's next.
What's ahead of you?
What's ahead of you? You can't see. But if they've given you the note that, you know, just take it flat out. So sometimes it's really tricky, but these are roads which have been given, where speed limits have been uplifted.
Mm-hmm.
And you're free to drive at any speed. And that is the same message we keep telling the fans. We keep telling the people in the villages.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes many are adamant. It's mm-hmm. unfortunate that such incidents happen, but I think FMU has done its
just
part.
Just enough.
It needs maybe to get back on the drawing board and see how better, you know, maybe safety can be improved.
Mm.
Yeah.
Finally, as we wrap it up, Mr. Nsereko, 2019, how much fortune do you think you'll bring from 2018 moving forward, especially in the two-wheel drive?
We are enthusiastic.
Mm.
We have 20 points in the bag now.
Mm-hmm.
And for us, that's a good start. I'm happy that the car came back.
In one piece.
We have another rally
that
to worry about.
That is always a major worry.
In about 25 days, there's another rally. Mm. So we are resting this week, and then next week we shall start the preparation.
Okay.
It's very important for us to always prepare ahead of the rally. And yeah.
Hopefully you will come out on top with John Bosco. Thank you so much, Nsereko, for coming through. I understand you're a doctor as well.
Yeah.
You treat patients? Which area exactly? Because now doctors, it cuts across.
Yes.
A gynecologist,
yes.
A neurosurgeon. Or
yes. I'm a pharmacist,
okay.
And a public health specialist.
Interesting.
Yes.
Not only is he a race driver, but also a doctor as well. That is an Nsereko Godfrey, who came out on top during the weekend's two-wheel drive, claiming maximum points. Round two set to unfold in a few weeks from now. Still.